Blackstone Audio presents The Most Successful Small Business in the World, The 10 Principles by Michael E. Gerber.
He who has a why to live for can bear with almost any how. Nietzsche.
Foreword. My first encounter with Michael Gerber was divine providence. It was certainly more than coincidence, and in any case, I share Einstein's view that coincidence is God's way of remaining anonymous. When I first met Mr. Gerber, I was 36 years old, and he was 71. I had been working as a Chabad rabbi in Malibu, California for 13 years. Like all Chabad emissaries, I was moved and inspired by our great leader, Rabbi Menachem Mendel Schneerson, best known simply as the Rebbe. The Rebbe arrived in America after fleeing Nazi-occupied Europe. In response to the atrocities of the war, he determined that the world needed a profound and lasting reorientation and set out to make it happen. He believed that if one evil human being could bring such tragedy to our planet, then certainly a concentrated effort involving millions of people could create a world of goodness and kindness. The Rebbe envisioned our world as God intended it to be, one where the beautiful divine potential that exists in all of us is present in every aspect of our lives. He stated that selfishness, anger, and jealousy are all products of a cover-up, and when the mask is lifted, our inner beings can shine through. The result will be a world of true inner peace, joy, and harmony. When I read Michael Gerber's book, The E-Myth Revisited, I had a surprising spiritual experience that made me feel that I must meet the writer. I was touched by his words, "I will never again let the curtain go down." Something about that sentiment and the work that I do as a Chabad rabbi told me that Mr. Gerber's methods and attitude could help me achieve my work on behalf of the Rebbe's dream. I was aware that Michael Gerber had been an inspiration to thousands of small business owners, and that he might not be easy to reach, but that never stopped me. Despite my calling the wrong office to contact him, somehow he received the message that a rabbi was trying to reach him. We made an appointment, and together with a few other rabbis, we had our first meeting. I will forever cherish the energy of that encounter. In my line of work, I constantly meet with people of all ages and backgrounds. I find that when people reach a certain stage in life, they're often content with who they are and what they do, or at least they accept their current place in the world. While this sense of satisfaction may have some benefits, the Rebbe spoke strongly about never being content when it comes to our spiritual growth. Michael Gerber exuded a gentle yet strong spirit that was inspiring. Here was a man in his 70s who could easily retire. Yet the youthful, ever-seeking energy within him wouldn't consider anything of the sort. He had a vital exuberance, as if he'd just gotten started with his entrepreneurial passion. He was like a 25-year-old trapped in a 71-year-old body. It was extraordinary. I remember Michael telling us about his limited involvement with Judaism, including the rabbi who convinced him not to become one, as well as the other great inspirational moments connected to his Jewish upbringing. But there was one story that validated my desire to meet him. Michael described the time when he joined a group who wanted to get together so they could discuss Jewish culture. In one of the first meetings, Michael brought up the scary elephant in the room that everyone else seemed to be avoiding. He expressed the fact that if they were going to do something Jewish together, then surely God must be part of the discussion. When his suggestion was denied, he decided to opt out. Why did this intrigue me so much? It intrigued me because our world has become accustomed to avoiding the important questions. We have stopped seeking. We have stopped talking to our inner child. We routinely dodge the core philosophical questions, such as, what is the purpose of life? Why does one get married? Why does one have children? What do we really want out of life? Fundamental issues have become unwelcome topics in our day-to-day lives, as we are caught up in the material world around us, as we try to earn a living and provide for our families. And here was a man who still wanted to explore. Here was a man who was unwilling to make any issue, even the God issue, off limits. A true breath of fresh air. Being alive requires a constant expression of life. Things that have life grow. People grow. Animals grow. Plants grow. Only lifeless stones cannot grow. Michael Gerber is committed to growth, and his gift is to help others grow as well. He hit the mark when he wrote, "Most business owners are not entrepreneurs, but technicians suffering from an entrepreneurial seizure." He himself is not just a technician. He hasn't closed the door on his inner child by silencing questions and just going through the motions. He is living his mantra in his own ongoing journey of personal discovery. I now realize that when Michael is communicating his message to business owners, he is actually sharing his deep desire that others remain open and connected to their inner child. Wikipedia defines an entrepreneur as a person who has possession of an enterprise or venture and assumes significant accountability for the inherent risks and the outcome. He or she is someone who is willing to converse with their inner child, despite the risks and fears involved, with what and where it may bring them. As Michael puts it, a business without a dream is like a life without a purpose, and an entrepreneur is always connected to the dream because he is also thinking about his purpose. I can tell you that Michael Gerber is just the man I was looking for when I tracked down the inspiring author of The E-Myth Revisited. His partnership and participation in the Rebbe's dream continues to be invaluable. In these pages, I expect that you will discover a soulful approach towards your future goals, and I pray that you too will never close the door on your inner child. Rabbi Levi Kunin, Malibu, California.
The annals of American business are filled with impossible dreams that have come true. I believe in those dreams. And most importantly, I believe in my dream. Mary Kay Ash, The Mary Kay Way. A brief introduction. But I am being reborn, and I need to take new risks. Paulo Coelho, The Zaire. I have been thinking about this book and writing it in my mind's eye since my very first book, The E-Myth, Why Most Small Businesses Don't Work and What to Do About It, was published in 1986. Since then, an intense but not nearly active enough dialogue has ensued between me and my readers throughout the world. Intense because to a person who owns a broken small business, as most of my readers do, the thesis that I raised in the E-Myth has found a treasured place in their hearts and minds. More about that in a moment. Not nearly active enough because although I have spoken with thousands of readers over the past 3 decades, I have not had a personal dialogue with most of the more than 3 million business owners and entrepreneurs who have read some or all of my books. Readers like you, perhaps, who have read The E-Myth but have never contacted me to discuss what I shared with you in the book and what happened to you after you read it. Readers like many others who never even thought to contact me because the reader of a book doesn't think that the author would be interested in having a conversation with them or would ever respond to them if they did. Readers like still others who, once having read the book or a part of it, yes, there are many I know who start a book and never finish it, go back to their business without ever having...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, Use the link in the video description.